Good morning, children. Welcome back to your math session. I hope you are all well and good. And this is your chapter 14 in your NCERT math book. That is your SMART charts. The chapter SMART charts means the theme is belonging and regarding to your data handling portion. Last year in 3rd standard, you already learned some data handling. Okay. What is mean by data handling? Data handling means it's nothing else. It just collects some information from the groups. Okay. So now in your book, this is your 14th chapter. So we just observe this picture here. Look at the picture, all of you. See, some children are watching television and some children are listening radio. Okay, children, let's move to our chapter. Here they are asking how many hours. That means they have to ask some questions regarding this current situation. So, yes, I just read the first line of this. All of us enjoy watching television or listening to the radio. I just ask you the same question with you, children. You are all like to watch a television or like to listen a radio? Yes, obviously in this generation, all of the children could like to watch the television alone, isn't it? But it is not good. So just I move for you. And next, see you. How much time do we spend in this? They are asking for watching a television or else you are listening a radio, how much time you are going to spend. And the note they give a note. The time you spend in front of TV or radio every day, do this for 1 week. The time spent in a week is dash hours. They are asking for you are watching a TV or else listening a radio throughout the week. For a week, how many days? You all know, for a week you have a 7 days. Per day, day one, how many hours you are watched out the TV or listen the radio. For example, day one you are watching a TV for 2 hours. Continuously, you continue your hours like that. 2 hours, 6 hours, or else 4 hours, 1 hour, like that. So you have to calculate for a whole week, that is 7 days, into 7 days. You have to multiply with that 7 days, okay? So now I just give an example here. You just, per day, I am just watch out the TV, okay? So for per day, 2 hours, I'm watching a television or else listening the radio. So which implies 7 days. What do you get for 7 days? So you have to multiply with 7 into 2. What do you get? 7 twos are, it's become 14. 14 are, that means therefore for 1 week, you are just watching a 14 hours TV or else listen the radio. Can you understand? And next question, listen. Here they are asking. So, in a month, you spend about dash. Per month, how many days you have? They are given out here 30 days. So, I just compute here. Can you understand? Now, I just multiply with 2 into 30 because I am watching per day 2 hours television or listening radio. So, they are asking to calculate per month. 1 month you have a 30 days or less 31 days. But here they mention the 30. So, you have to multiply 30 into 2. What you get? 2 zeros or 0 or else 2 six or. So that means 2 threes are 6. So per month, this is per day. I'm sorry, listen. दिस इज 2 hours पर डे, तो 30 into 2 यू गॉट अ 60 hours. कैन यू गॉट पॉइंट? ओके ओके चिल्ड्रन, लेट्स सॉल्व दिस सम विच इज डिस्प्लेड ऑन योर एनसीईआरटी बुक. I just read the question. Note the time you spend in front of a TV or radio every day. That is, we already done. We have per day, we are assumed the 2 hours we are watching a TV or radio, listening the radio. Do this for 1 week. The time spent in a week is, that is, what you spend time per week, you have a 7 days into 2 hours. What actually you get? That is 14. 14 hours you are watching for a week. And so in a month you spend about 30. That is again you have to multiply with 2. You have to, what you get actually 32s, or you got a 60. So 60 hours you are watching per a month. That is, or listening a radio. Now you are again, they are asking some question. Find out from your friends the time they spend in a week. This is you have to gather the information from your friends. But I just wrote you some assumption informations. Okay, so how many hours they watch a TV or listen to the radio in a week? That is, you are writing 7 days. In a week means that is 7 days. Okay, so now listen, more than 6 hours, the number of children will be 4. And 6 hours, exactly 6 hours will be your, that is 5. And how many hours? 5 hours will be your children, that is 2. Number of children will be 2. And 4 hours, it may be the some maximum number of students, that is, I will just give out the 8. Okay, 3 hours will be 10 children will watch out the 3 hours, and 2 hours will be the 12 children's. 1 hour, the maximum number 1 hour will be 14. Okay, and the last question is, what they asking? 0 hour do not watch a TV. It's not possible, isn't it? Because the now children nowadays, they won't leave without watching a TV. So I just put a dash. No, it is impossible. So now you understand, this is the way how to you distribute the information. Whatever the collecting information, you distribute like this. Understand? From, and next thing you have to learn, you just one question is your, I can watch a TV for 24 hours, it is a good or bad for me? Obviously 24 hours means one whole day. We can't watch TV for whole day. It is a very bad to have a health, isn't it? So no, it is obviously bad. Okay, can you understand? Okay, from the given data, they are asking some questions. Either watching TV or listening to the radio. So dash children spend more than 6 hours in a week. So for this, you have to move on previous one. How many children is more than week for watching a television or listening? 4 children will be watching out, isn't it? So we have to compute that. So 4 children are watching 6 hours in a week. And dash children spend no time at all. So spend no time at all. That means nil. No one children, no nothing. It is impossible. The children, no one shouldn't live without watching a TV or listen the radio. So that is 0. Most children spend dash hours in a week. Most means, which are the children are more spending the in a week? That is only the I just 1 hour. That is 14 children are most. And next, last question. The children spend more than 3 hours. That is more than 3 hours. How many children are spending more than 3 hours? Listen, more than 3 hours means from here. What do you get? 8 children. This is, and I just thought this is a 4 hours overall watching. 8, so 8 plus, and again 2 in a 5 hours plus, and 6 hours will be your 5, and then 4 for more than 6. So totally 8 plus 2 will be your 10, and 10 plus 5 will be 15. 15 plus 4, you got a 19. 19 children are spending a time more than 3 hours. Can you understand? Now I just write over here. Who are all the children? We just compute, okay? Listen. So, how many children spend more 6 hours? So, 6 hours is more than 4 children. And dash children spend no time at all. That is 0. And most children spend dash hours in a week. Most children's dash hour week, now 1 hour in a week. And then dash children spend more than 3 hours. We just compute that it is total more than 3 hours. So 19 children are spending more than 3 hours. And this is your children's second question. That's from your NCRT. Find out from 20 friends the program they like and dislike and write in a table. That is programs. The kinds of program they given out in the tables. That is news, serials, cartoons, comedy shows and sports. Number of children like it. And next column will be a number of children dislike it. So we have to go through this. Understand? Example. We just compute this. Afterwards, we go through the questions. Okay. So first, this is also my assumption. I just put a numbers. The number of children, those are like this program. Those are not dislike this program. Okay. So now from the first one, what they get? The news. How many children like to watch it? The news. So we just put it. Number of children will be the 2. 2 children can like to watch a news. And number of children dislike it. So most of 10 children, they won't like to watch a news. Serials. Serials means it means the only one students or for we can put just 4 children can like to watch a serials. And most of the children could not like to watch a serials. So our mothers only like to watch a serials, isn't it? Cartoons. Yes, it is a very favorite for all the children. So I just put the maximum number of children here for cartoon. Okay, for cartoon I just write a 16 children. Dislike means just 2. And comedy shows. Comedy shows also, most of the children they like a comedy shows. Those who I put the 14 in a number. And this is I just put a 0. Okay, sports. So children they can like to watch a sports, isn't it? So we just give some number, increased number. So I will get 12. And they do not like to watch a sports means just 4. Okay. Now you understand what I'm saying. So this is a table they given out the. So number of children like to news is 2 and dislike is 10. And number of children like to watch serials 4, dislike 8. And this is your cartoon they like to watch 16 children and dislike children will be 2. And comedy shows 14 and 0 is dislike. Sports 12 and dislike 4. So from this chart we are going to we are going to answer the following questions from this given table. Okay, so you observe the questions. You just observe the question. First question, which kind of program is liked by most children? Most children has liked to watch, that is your 16 cartoon shows. So I just write on here cartoons every children like to watch. All right. And next, second question. Now I'm going to second question. Which kind of program is disliked by the least number of children? Disliked means what is that? Least number of children, that is very less in number. Dislike means that is cartoon. Okay, again cartoon only they dislike. Cartoon, this is for this answer also, because the cartoon is very favorite for all the children, isn't it? So the least number will be occurs in cartoons. And the third question, how many children like sports program? So likes they asking. So likes means that is a maximum number, that is 14 children can like to watch a sports program. And the fourth question is there any kind of program not liked by anyone? Yes or no? If yes, which one that? See, the dislike circle. Some of the children, they dislike all the programs, isn't it? So we won't mention your yes. So no children like that. So in dislike categories, some children are appear. So no one we can mention in this categories. Understand? Okay, this is your chart. And this is one of the kind of your data handling portion. And here the chart is displayed to exhibit the children's paper getting participating in some drama. Okay. So I just here, this side, the each, you just listen here. The each triangle will be shows the three children. That is one children, that one triangle is equal to three children's. Okay, so like that you have to calculate all the children's. So the different categories, the program categories is here, that is acting and collecting dresses, playing music, making the sets. So drama, for drama we have to acting students, these students. For acting portion, some students they're getting the collecting their dresses, and also some students they are playing the music behind the drama. And some students, they're making the sets. What is sets? In the wall pictures. They're making the wall picture for the recordings this drama. Okay. Now, we just compute how many children in each section. Okay. That is, each session we have to. I already told you, one triangle is equal to the three. So, now, this is three and three and your three. So total how much you get? Your 9. So 9 children in acting. Okay. Again collecting dresses, there are 3 in plus 3. So what you get? You get a 6 children for collecting a dress. And 4 playing a music. So your 4. So 4 into 3, we can easily do this. 12 children for playing a music. And here again making a sets. Only the 2 children are getting participant. Each one is will be the equal to 3. So 2 into 3. What do you get? 6. Okay. So now I can easily explain you. This is what I said. So for acting, how many children? So we get a 3 into 3. It's become 9. For collecting dresses, 2 into 3. That is 6 children's. For playing a music, 4 into 3 will become 12. And for making a sets, it's a 2 into 3. You get a 6 children's. Okay, children. From the given data, we can answer these questions all. Okay. So, I just short out here. For acting, 9 students is here. For collecting letters, I have a 6. For playing a music, 12. And making sets will be your again 6. Okay. Now listen. First question is, how many children are acting in a drama? Totally they are asking. Acting in a drama. Actually these categories are they are helping for a drama, but acting persons only the 9. Now you just go to for the second question. Which are more, that is children making a sets or those act? So obviously collecting the set is 6 and but acting number is 9. So more they asking, obviously the which is more, the children making those or acting is more than collecting the dress. So 9 numbers. And third question, listen, which is being done by most of the children? Which is most, the word most means increased one, that is So most of the children are like to playing the music. Music is the very big, that is 12 numbers. It is very comparatively other, the 12 is more than other numbers. So that is playing music. Okay, so we have to that. And next, how many children are collecting dresses? So obviously it's directly is here, 6 children are collecting dresses. So you understand here, and this is a way how do you describe the from the chart and answer the questions as following. Okay, so shall we move to next? Now children, it's quite interesting. Listen, your one poem is displaying here on your NCRT. I just read out this. Who is my friend? That is the heading of your poem. The first one. I have a friend with me always, in the nights and through the days. When I run, he runs with me. Sometimes I lead, sometimes he. When it's dark, he can't be seen. Do you know which friend I mean? So superb, isn't it? So listen, this is a... You have to observe this picture. From this picture alone, you have answer for this puzzle. Listen, who is our friend? They're always mentioning. So, in throughout his friends with him, in day and night. But in dark, we can't see him. So, is it only the way see a darkness? This is a shadow of the tree and shadow of a person. So, the answer is shadow. Understand. So, and let's come to another quite interesting thing. Listen, from this poem they are asking some questions. Read the poem carefully and answer these questions. First question, what is this? Which word comes most often in the poem? So here I just read, I have a friend with me always, in the nights and through the days. When I run, he runs with me. Sometimes I lead, sometimes he. When it is dark, he can't see, be seen. Do you know which friend I mean? So here I is most oftenly occurring word. Almost 4 times it will be occurring, isn't it? So the which word comes most often in the poem means that is I. It is not a letter you are mentioning. I means that person, the particular person is mentioning. Which letter has been used most? That is your second question. Which letter has been most used means you have to see this. See the poem. Which letter is coming oftenly? The letter, every and each and every line, the E, you just notice the, note down that. Okay, you just note down each line, the E is occurs most. From this line alone, or the first line alone, you have a, how many E's is there? For I have the 1, 2, 3, okay, again the second line 4 and 5, third line 6, 7, 8, like that. So E is your most occur word, and I is your, that is E is your letter, most occurred letter, I is your word. And which letters comes least? Now the third question, which is least? From this poem you just observed which is very least. So alphabet A is oftenly occurs, the alphabet B. Now I just go through the B is opening here. Yes, here only one B is here, B, and there is no other B. So I just observe, so B is the least word, again the, after B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, like you have to arrange all the alphabet from A to Z and C one by one. So here I just seen the H also oftenly occurred. So here only the another word is have, that is I have, that V, you just see the V here. So V, the B and V is the least letters that comes in a poem. Understand? And this is the time for your assignment for this chapter. So I just give what you done in previous. Okay, take a paragraph you like from your language textbook, that is your English reader. From your English reader you can take any paragraph, from poem paragraph or prose paragraph, that is your wish. Read carefully and find out, that is the following question you have to answer it. So which word comes most often, how many times, and which word comes least often, and third one, the letter used most often is, and the letter used least often is. So you just listen, you have to get a clarified the word and the letter. Okay, so I just give one hint for this. You just write a A to Z alphabet and just you observe from each and every end how many times A occurs, and each and every word how many times a B occurs. Like that you have to observe and write a table. Then it is easily you can observe how you can compute these type of questions. And now here comes at the end of the session. Thank you children. We can see you on next video. Take care. Bye bye.